Hey, it's me, Robbie, the host of Matescium. Welcome back. Simple question here. If I ask you what's the result of 2 plus 2? I know you'd say 2 plus 2 is equal to 4, but I say 2 plus 2 is not equal to 4. I have a new trick that would prove 2 plus 2 is equal to 5. It seems like insane thinking, right? Just sit back and relax. You will see 2 plus 2 is 5. Maybe you can remember I had uploaded a similar video and that video got around 4 million views. But in this episode, I am applying a different trick. Before watching this video, you promise me, if you can catch the mistake in this calculation, you will subscribe to this channel. On the other hand, if you can't catch the mistake, you will subscribe and share this video. Well, let's prove that 2 plus 2 is equal to 5. Let's consider 0 is equal to 0. And then this 0 can be written as 4 minus 4 because of this 4 minus 4 is equal to 0. Similarly, that 0 can also be written as 10 minus 10. Look at here. 10 minus 10, 0. And 4 minus 4 is also 0. That means those two mathematical statements can go back and forth and they are supported by each other. The next step is this 4 can be written as 2 square. And this 2 square means 4. Minus is here. And this 4 can also be written as 2 square. On the right hand side, this 10 can be written as 5 times 2. Minus that 10 also be written as 5 times 2. The next step is a simple formula, x square minus y square. We know this formula from our childhood. X square minus y square is equal to x plus y times x minus y. This formula can be applied here. Imagine this 2 as x and that 2 as y. So I am gonna to apply this formula exactly here. So left hand side can be rewritten as 2 plus 2 times 2 minus 2. On the right hand side, this 5 and that 5 can be taken as a common 5. This 2 is here inside the bracket, minus, and that 2 is here. Now, this is the most interesting part of this calculation. Look at the left hand side. This 2 minus 2 and there is another 2 minus 2 on the right hand side. They are equal. So those 2 minus 2 on left hand side and that 2 minus 2 on the right hand side, they are cancelled each other. The remaining is 2 plus 2 on left hand side and 5 on the right hand side. That means finally we got 2 plus 2 is equal to 5. You might feel, aha, how is it possible, right? The actual secret is hidden in this entire calculation. I intentionally did not follow the ground rules of mathematics in this entire calculation. That means I hacked the fundamental behavior of mathematics. That's why this strange result came out. Well, if you know where exactly the mistake in this calculation is, write your opinion in the comment section of this video. You can mention the line number 1, 2, 3, 4, or even line number 5 in your comments. Which line has the origin of the mistake? That means a source of mistake is responsible for these funny results. Unfortunately, most of the people cannot catch the origin of this funny result. So your task is find out what's the reason why this funny result happened. Where is the origin of this mistake? I have another similar video. I asked the same question there. Most of the audience replied that I made mistake on this part because first I have to work out here according to the Bodmash rules. That case, this 2 minus 2 is 0 and that part also become to 0. So both side turns into 0 is equal to 0. Yeah, partially you are right. But my question was, where is the origin of the mistake? The purpose of this video is to show you what if you make a mistake. If you make a mistake, it may lead a strange result. That was my purpose to make this video. Do not take it seriously. If you love mathematics, I request you to subscribe to this channel.
Hey, I have a bonus video for you guys. Do you know one of the most interesting number pattern is called Pascal triangle? This Pascal triangle is pretty much interesting. Let me draw what is Pascal triangle by using the basic numbers. Let's say first you have to write a 1 here and then write 1 this side, another 1 this side. It's form a triangle, right? Let's make it a little bit bigger. Write another one here and add these two numbers. 1 plus 1 is 2 and write that 2 in between that two number a little bit below. And another one is here. Now, the triangle is getting bigger, right? Okay, let's expand it more and more. So, I'm writing another one here and this 1 plus 2 is 3. Write this 3 in between these two number a little bit below. Then 2 plus 1 is also 3. And this one is here. Now I'm writing again another one here. 1 plus 3 is 4. 3 plus 3 is 6. In between here, write it 6. 3 plus 1 is 4. And this one here. Look at this shape. It's exactly shaped like a triangle, right? For that reason, it's called Pascal triangle. There is no limit. You can expand it as long as you want. I'm expanding one more step further ahead. 1 plus 4 is 5. 4 plus 6 is 10, 4 plus 6 is again 10, and 4 plus 1 is 5, and this is 1. So now it is getting perfect triangle. Question is, what's the application of this Pascal triangle, right? We know there is different formulas. Let's say a plus b whole square. It is quite difficult to remember all those formula, right? Maximum we can remember this one and that one, but rest of them, for example, a plus b to the power 7 or a power b to the power 8, it's quite difficult to remember. So what is the way to find out all those formula? The way is use this Pascal formula or Pascal triangle. Using this Pascal triangle, you can apply all those, you can get all those values or all those formula within very short time. I have another video how to find out this formula by using this Pascal triangle. You can have a look.
Thank you so much for watching, and before we leave, please hit the subscribe button.